Someone look at somebody, tell me, say, I'm free. Oh, you know what freedom really feels like. Come on, somebody just say, thank God I'm free. What had my mind last year don't have it no more. What had my heart last year don't have it no more. Somebody shout, thank God I'm free. You can have joy just cause you choose to have joy. Look at somebody, tell them, neighbor, I don't really have anything that I can use to point toward my joy. But tell them, I got it because I choose to have it. I got it because I choose to have it. Because the joy of the Lord. Look at somebody, tell them, I'm getting stronger by the moment. I'm getting stronger by the moment. I'm getting stronger by the praise. I'm getting stronger by the shout. I'm getting stronger by the leap. Because the joy. Oh! Ooh-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I dare you just get you a dance and start dancing like you got joy. God's getting ready to perform it. Look at somebody and say, I'm out of speaking season. I spoke it last year, but this is the performing season. I declared it last year, but this is manifestation. I waited last year, but this time I'm going to receive it. I sowed last year, but this year I'm going to reap. So look into your future and see what God has in store for you and call it to come forth now. Look at somebody and tell them, you got to have the spirit of now. Not tomorrow, but right now. My first shout was a shout of need, and my second shout is a shout of victory. And could that be the reason why some of us have not been fully delivered? Because our shouts have only been shouts of need. But I guarantee if you stand on your feet and shout right now, you'll get a complete deliverance in you. Some stuff you ain't gonna have to worry about no more. Very often, people who do business with God will experience contrary winds. These winds were designed to keep them from their appointed purpose. All they had to do to overcome these contrary winds is turn around, but touch your neighbor and say, I'm too close to turn around now. So the Bible says that Jesus saw them toiling at ruin. I don't understand it, but I'm ruined. It looks like death is certain, but I'm ruined. I got tears in my eyes. But I'm ruined. Folks are laughing at me. But I'm ruined. It doesn't seem like I'm gonna make it. But I'm ruined. I'm the president of the choir. And everybody's not working with me like they ought to. But I'm ruined. My ushers don't come to church on time like they ought to. Sometime they got to be ushered in. But I'm ruined. I have Sunday school teachers that won't tithe, won't do what they're supposed to do. But me as a pastor, look at your neighbor and say, you got to keep on ruining. Yes, sir, I think I'm going to close this thing. Oh, Lord, help me out. I got to keep on rowing. And every time you come to church, just look at your neighbor and tell him you're rowing. Why, every time you pick up your Bible, you're rowing. Every time you wave your hand and say, yes, Lord, you're rowing.
Look at your neighbor and say, keep on rowing. Because Jesus is on the way. Oh, Lord. The Bible said, yeah, while they were rowing, Jesus was coming. The text seems to suggest that time Jesus comes to those who try. Oh, Lord, and not to those who give up. Oh, Lord, just touch somebody and say, neighbor, neighbor, you got to keep on rowing. Yeah, may not seem like you're gonna make it, but keep on rowing. Get frustrated sometimes, but keep on rowing. Sometimes you feel like giving up, but you gotta keep on rowing. Shout, yeah, yeah. And while they were rowing, Jesus was coming in their direction. Yeah, and the Bible said that Jesus came during the fourth watch of the night. Oh, Lord, every night is broken up into four watches. Yes, the first watch is called the evening watch, and that's from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. Yeah, second watch is called the midnight watch, and that's from 9 p.m. to 12 a.m. Oh, Lord. The third watch is called the cock crowing watch, and that's from 12 a.m. to 3 a.m. Do you hear me? The fourth watch is called the morning watch, and that's from 3 a.m. to 6 a.m. Great God, some of you today, you've been rowing, and it's about morning time. Oh, Lord, somebody here is about three strokes away. Oh, Lord, tell your neighbor, you gotta keep on rowing. Yeah, Lord, yay, yay, I got to keep on rowing. Jesus came during the fourth watch of the night, and that's called the morning watch. Yeah, I heard the writer say, weeping. Well, y'all ain't go help me. Say, weeping, I may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. Oh, Lord, it's morning time in somebody's life. If you jump up on your feet and give the Lord some praise, Jesus, he's coming to your rescue. Shout, yay! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah, Lord. Jesus came during the fourth watch of the night. Oh, Lord. And when he gets there, they think it's a ghost, but Jesus is walking on the sea. And when he gets to them, Jesus' first words was, cheer up. I know you're going through, but cheer up. Take somebody by the hand and say, neighbor, as long as you're negative, you'll attract negative things. Kind begets kind. But if you want Jesus to come on board, you got to cheer up. Give about three people a high five and say, cheer up, cheer up. I know you're going through, but cheer up. Put a smile on your face, and Jesus, he'll come to your rescue. Shout, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Shout, yeah. Yeah. And not only cheer up, but Jesus told him to fear not. Lord, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love and of power and of a sound mind. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you gotta adjust your attitude. Your attitude determines your altitude, and not only Should you adjust your attitude? You gotta adjust your psyche. Shoddy, yeah. And Jesus said, I am he that was dead, but I'm alive forevermore. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, Jesus, he's the mayor of my city. Jesus, he's the governor of my state. Jesus, he's the president of my country. Jesus, he'll pick you up. Jesus, he'll turn you around. Jesus, he'll fight your battles. Shout yay! Shout yay! Yay! Lordy! Yay!